What's up, Facebook? What's up, Facebook? My wife said nothing. My wife said nothing is up. All right? She said nothing's up. What am I gonna go over in this video? Oh, I'm gonna show you guys some stuff.
Oh yeah, some interesting stuff.
I'm gonna show you guys some stuff. Specifically, yeah, they're gonna see some stuff. Specifically, what I'm gonna show you is I'm gonna show you guys how I actually keep my friends list clean and basically get rid of people who don't engage with my content, which basically hurt the rest of my content. So I'm gonna show you how I find those people, how I identify them, how I actually easily get them off of my friends list and make sure that I'm actually removing the right people off of my friends list and I'm not removing prospective buyers that are helping me with my content and my engagement. And then I'm going to show you how I actually replace all of those people with brand new friends. So, and I'm going to show you how I do all of that on autopilot while I'm busy doing other stuff like my day-to-day stuff that I actually have to do. I'm going to show you guys how I actually do all of that. All right. So first off, we're going to actually look and see. All right. So this is my face. Oh, you guys can't see. You guys can't see. So let me make it where you can see. There you go. Well, you probably want to see me still, right? Yeah, I'm sure you want to see me still. So I'll stay down here. All right. So first off, if you look at my Facebook profile, you can see I have 4,998 friends, so I can't really accept too many more friends. Can't really have so many more friends, so what I need to do on a consistent basis is go through and basically prune my friends list, go through and basically get rid of the people who don't really engage in my content and are kind of just like dead weight on my friends list. We're friends for no real apparent reason. They don't like checking out my content. They don't have Messenger conversations with me. They're just basically being on my friends list, being useless. So basically what I need to do is I need to get rid of those people and then replace them with new people who can be, you know, my ideal customer avatar. So I'm going to show you how I go in and do that. I use different software tools to actually automate this entire process for me. So I'm going to go in and actually show you Friender. This is a software that I'm actually using to help me automate this actual process. So part of what I'm going to do on a daily basis, and this actually runs automatically, so I don't actually have to do anything. This will actually run automatically, but I'm just going to show you guys, if it didn't run automatically, what I would do. I would basically just go in here and click the Sync Now button. And once I click the Sync Now button, basically what Friender is going to do is it's going to grab all this information for me. So it's going to go in and basically sync up with Facebook, sync up my friends list, and grab the associated data about my friends list. For example, it's gonna grab their profile picture, their name, I'm gonna infer their gender, I'm gonna get what we believe is their country and the tier level of their country. That way I can realize, you know, hey, like this person from a tier 3 country here, tier 3 countries usually don't have disposable income. These tier levels are actually classifications that come from the World Banks, and they're classifications based on the total GDP per capita of a population. So, for example, United States and France are tier 1 countries, which typically means that those countries, the tier 1 countries, they just have more disposable income. So it's just easier to sell products and services to those people because they just actually have more money. Whereas the tier 3 countries, it's harder to sell stuff to them. All right. Then I'm going to get to actually see where these friends came from. So did they come from me sending a friend request? Did they send me a friend request? These friends right here, they came from this initial sync process. So we don't really know where they came from. We just know when we started using Friender and we synced up our friends list, those friends magically appeared, all right? So don't really know where they came from. We just know they were on our friends list when we actually started. Then I see the total reactions that they've left on my post. I'm gonna see how many comments they've left on my post. I'm gonna see how many messages they've actually left on my post and if we've actually had a conversation or not. All right, so now I have all the actual information, and then what I'm going to do is you can see over here, I can see the age, how long they've actually been on my friends list. Now, this is how long they've been on my friends list from Friender's perspective, all right? So when you first start using Friender and you do your initial sync, everybody will be basically 1 minute old, even if they've been on your friends list for a year or 2 years, because we don't really know how long they've been on your friends list because Facebook doesn't give us that information. We do know how long Friender has actually known about them and how long it's been since Friender first saw the person on your friends list. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna basically come over here to this message count where this message count is zero. And what I'm gonna be looking for is I'm gonna be looking for people like this who are 13 days old and we haven't had any type of communication whatsoever. So I'm gonna be looking at people like this where I see all zeros. So I see this person right here. They've been on my friends list for 13 days. They haven't engaged in any of my posts. They haven't commented on any of my posts and we don't have any messages. So I'm gonna be clicking this person, 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 this person. All right, so now we got 12 friends selected. All right, so if you remember, I basically had 4,998 friends over here, and now over here I've got 12 friends selected. And you can see all these friends, they've been on my friends list for 2 weeks, all right? That's plenty of time for them to have actually checked out my content, maybe left a like, or maybe, you know, left a comment, or maybe even have a message with me, but they haven't done that. So probably they're not interested in consuming my content. Probably they're not interested in the types of stuff that I talk about. So probably they're not interested in having conversations with me. So I'm going to make an inference that they're probably not interested in buying my shit, and they're probably not going to be ideal customers of mine. And the reason for that is, if you kind of think of intent-based sales, and that's pretty much how all sales are, all right? So let's say you have a person over here, you have a start over here, and over here you have, I don't want to say an end goal, because this isn't actually really the end goal. Once somebody gets over here where they become a customer, then basically your goal is actually to ascend them up a value ladder and get them to be repeat customers and buy stuff over and over and over again, all right? But from the time you actually get a lead, a person is going to essentially go on a journey to become your customer, right? So somebody is going to come in, you can say, okay, hey, however you're getting leads, somebody's actually going to come in, and this actual entire process right here is kind of like a double funnel if you look at it, all right? So people are going to be coming in, and then they're going to go through some journey and some process for them to actually become a paying customer. And then, like I said, once they become a paying customer and you get some money from them, the process doesn't end. Your goal then is to actually, you know, ascend them up a value ladder here and get them to be repeat customers and buy stuff over and over and over again, all right? And this whole journey, what's essentially happening through this journey is intents, all right? So like an intent one, intent two, intent three, intent four, intent five, et cetera, et cetera, okay? And the more intents that happen, each intent that happens, the person, as you can see, they get closer to becoming a paying customer. So now what I can tell from these people is no intents have happened, all right? We've connected for whatever reason, either I sent them a friend request or they sent me a friend request, and we've connected, we've been friends for 13 days, but since in those 13 days, there's been no intents, so they've got no closer to becoming a paying customer of mine. And since I don't have room for any more friends, they're gonna be the first people to go, all right? So now if I wanna go in and find more of them, I can go in and find more of them. Here's another one, here's another one, here's another one, another one, another one, another one, another one, another one. Here's one right here. They're the same, they've been on my friends list for 13 days, but look, they've engaged in 14 of my posts and they've left a comment on one of my posts, all right? So that person's going to stay because they've actually, that person's gonna stay because they're actually engaging with my content, which means that they're getting closer and closer to becoming a paying customer of mine. So they're going to actually stay, I'm not going to remove them, but then I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna just select the rest of these people. And as you can see, I'm giving everybody a chance. So I gave them 13 days and they didn't wanna engage or anything, so I'm gonna actually make some room for some new people to come on my friends list and give them a chance to actually go through the same process. All right, so now I've got 26 friends selected, and then what I'm gonna do is I'm just going to actually click right up here, and then I'm gonna click this unfriend button, And then once I click this unfriend button, they're going to actually start getting unfriended. All right. So now what will happen is all these people will now actually get unfriended, and you can see that this person has actually been unfriended. And what will happen is one by one, the software, now I can go off and do whatever I want. I don't have to be here doing this. I can go off and do whatever I want. And then one by one, the software will go in and actually unfriend these people. And then I'll be able to see over here the people who are actually getting unfriended as they actually get unfriended. I can see I've already unfriended 27 people. So there's already been 27 people that have essentially got unfriended because, again, they've been on my friends list long enough. They haven't engaged in any of my content. We haven't had any messenger conversations. They haven't got any closer to becoming a paying customer of mine. And since I don't have any additional room left on my friends list, I'm gonna get rid of them, and then I'm gonna go find some new people that are, again, my ideal target avatar, and then I'm going to go in and actually replace those people. So you can see this number is going to actually continue to grow. This 28, it's going to go in, and one by one, it's actually going to start unfriending these people. Just one by one, it will go in and unfriend everybody that I actually want. All right. So that's how I actually keep the list clean. Again, as you can see, there's lots of data that I'm using to actually drive my decisions as far as who's getting unfriended, who's not getting unfriended. All right. So if you guys have any questions about this process and you want to ask any questions about this process, just let me know. I'll try to actually answer your questions. But you can see, hey, that's actually growing. Each one of those people are actually getting unfriended. So now that everybody is actually getting unfriended there, so now as the software is actually getting unfriended, again, you can see I had 4998. And if I just refresh this page, I'll probably have like 6 less friends because I've unfriended some people already. So you can see I have 4995. So I've already unfriended 3 of those people automatically. And I'm making room now for more friends to actually get on my friends list. All right. So that's what's happening now. I'm making more friends. I'm making more room for more friends to actually get on my friends list. And then the software will just continuously unfriend those people. So here I'm at 29 people that I've unfriended already. And then you can see this guy was actually unfriended. That was Zach. And you can see all of these people are essentially being added over here. This was Zach that I just unfriended. You can see that me and Zach are no longer friends anymore. So sorry, Zach, but we just can't be friends anymore because apparently you don't like anything that I do or talk about. All right, so that's going to continue to happen. Those people are going to continuously get unfriended. Now I want to replace those. I want to replace these people that I'm unfriending with new leads that are my ideal customer avatar. So how I'm going to do that is I'm going to go into a group. All right, I'm going to go into a group. Now, for example, this group is a group for GroupKit, which is a software that's a little. It's a little similar to GroupMonkey. Doesn't have quite as many features as GroupMonkey, but it costs a little bit less money than GroupMonkey. So this is a very similar software to one of the softwares that I offer, one of the softwares that I actually sell that we've developed. I know my product is, at least I believe that my product is a better product, actually. Although this isn't the only product that I sell. And I notice all the time in here, people are nonstop talking about the software is not working, the software doesn't do this, the software doesn't do that. And I also know that all these people are using this software, most likely, and they're paying money to actually use the software. I know what the software does, and I know that because of that information, like I know who these people are, I know they use GroupKit, they're in this actual group, I know they're my ideal customer avatar because they're already using some type of Facebook automation software to help them grow their group on Facebook, which means that they're using Facebook to try to actually get clients to make more money, which means that they will be a perfect type of person to buy several of the different softwares that I actually have. So what I'm going to do is now I'm going to go in and I'm going to start connecting with these people. And I'm gonna start actually sending them friend requests. And how I'm gonna do that is, again, I'm just going to actually open up Friender. And now whenever I actually open up Friender, I've got some options here. Now I'm gonna filter by people who are in tier one countries, because that's what I'm looking for. And I'm gonna look for people who have these keywords. So either they're a CEO, they're an owner, they're a marketing, they're a marketer, they're an affiliate, they're self-employed. So I just put self, I'm gonna put founder. All right, so now I have these different keywords, all right? And that's what I'm going to actually look for, all right? So hopefully that makes sense. I'm gonna look for different friends. I'm going to send as many as I want right here. I'm actually just going to limit this to 10 people. All right. And then again, I'm going to search for people who are in tier one countries. Again, I told you guys kind of what the tier levels are. Those tier levels are essentially levels that are issued by the global banks, and they represent countries countries in different buckets based on GDP per capita. So tier one countries are the richest countries, tier two countries are underneath that, and tier three countries are the poorest countries. All right. Then I'm going to search for people based on these keywords, because these are the types of keywords that I know my ideal customer avatar has. And that's it. I'm going to now hit run. And then I'm going to let this software actually do its job. So now the software is going to actually do its job. And you can see it's instantly found a person right here. So it's already found this person right here called Joel. And it's going to send this person a friend request. All right. Now, in the meantime, while that is actually happening, remember, all these people are getting unfriended automatically by Friender. So Friender is going in and unfriending the dead weight, unfriending, and it's making room on my friends list for new friends from people who just don't engage in my content and are probably never going to buy something from me. So while those people are getting unfriended automatically from Friender, then Friender is also sending these people friend requests. So you can see here's another founder. And guess what? It's going to send this person a friend request. And then Friender is going to continue to go in, and it's going to look at people, found another founder and CEO, and it's going to send this person a friend request. And I could be doing whatever I want to do, all right? So I could go back in the back of my office and go to my gym and start lifting weights. Today's my arm day, so I could go finish doing my arms. And Friender will just actually do its job. Now, while I'm doing something else, Friender is literally getting rid of dead weight. So it's removing friends that don't engage in my profile, making room on my friends list for new friends. And then it's finding literally the ideal customer avatar that would buy my stuff. And it's adding them to my actual friends list. So friends are coming off, friends are going on, all at the same time, all completely on autopilot with just me clicking just a little bit of buttons. So you can kind of see up here, if we look at Friender, we can see that Friender's looked through 10 different profiles already, and it's found three people that actually match my criteria that I set, and it sent those three people friend requests. Now I ask it to only send 10 friend requests for me, and now it's actually working. You know, it's looked through 15 profiles, it sent four friend requests, and it seems like it just found this person right here, another CEO, and now it's going to actually send this person a friend request. So hopefully that makes sense. If you guys have any questions, feel free to ask those questions. I will answer those questions to the best of my ability if you guys have some questions. There we went, found another one. Found another founder. So again, we can see that we sent out four friend requests. We've looked at 21 different profiles. Now it's going to send another friend request for me. So my friends list is literally growing automatically on autopilot, and it's also shrinking on autopilot. All right. So it's getting rid of people who shouldn't be on there. I've looked at 26 profiles. I've sent five friend requests. I just found another one right here, another CEO. And then it's just going to automate sending that friend request for me. All right. Now I've set it to only send out 10 friend requests. You can have it send out as many as you want. So you can send out as many as you want. Just found another CEO and founder. So again, if we look, I've looked through 27 people automatically. It's scrolled through 27 people. It's filtered through 27 people. And out of those 27 people, it found five people that match my criteria. And again, my criteria was they have to be from a tier one country, and they have to have one of those keywords like founder, CEO, marketer, affiliate, any of those types of people I know are my ideal customer avatar. So Friender is actually doing its job. It found another founder and CEO for me, and it's going to send that friend request out for me. All right, and all of this is essentially happening on autopilot. I just click a couple buttons, then I go away and do, you know, I go spend time with my dog, play with my dog, I go work out, go eat corn with my wife, go do whatever I want. And this process, this process that I'm showing you right here is one step in the process that has allowed me to generate over $5 million from these random strangers on Facebook. I've been doing this now for about 4 years. And because of that, I've ended up building a bunch of different software to actually help me automate this process. So I'm not spending all of my time doing this mundane stuff and just clicking buttons. I can spend my time doing things that actually really push the needle in my business and actually help me make more money. And everything that actually can be automated, well, it's just going to go ahead and actually get automated for me. So again, we can look and see I've identified another owner and founder. And if we look, we can see, hey, I've looked through 39 people. I've already sent out 7 of the 10 friend requests that I've actually wanted to send. Now it's sending another one. This will be number 8. And then it has 2 more friend requests. Meanwhile, over here, these people have actually been unfriended. All the people that I wanted to unfriend, they've all now been unfriended. I went ahead and actually unfriended automatically the people, again, that actually weren't. So all I did was come over here and I found the people that actually are engaging in my content, like this person right here, like this person right here. They've been on my friends list for quite some time, for 13 days. They're not engaging in any of my content whatsoever. We're not having any type of conversations. So they're getting removed. As you can see, these people are getting unfriended automatically. The software is unfriending them automatically. And at the same time it's unfriending those people, it's also sending out my friend request, basically replacing the people that I'm removing that aren't engaging with my content, replacing them with new people that can go in and engage in my content. And then I'll just do this process every single day. Every single day I'll get rid of some friends and I'll get new friends. I'll get rid of some friends and I'll get new friends, and people will end up, some of those people will end up buying my products and services. And that's how I've been able to, there are a couple other processes. So now I've went in and what basically happened, I went in and I looked through 44 profiles and it sent 10 friend requests for me on autopilot. So looked through 44 profiles, it sent 10 friend requests for the people that actually matched the keywords that I was looking for. So I was sending to people on tier 1 countries that match any of these actual keywords. And now I'll see all those people over here on my pending friend requests. They're all people who are now pending because I've actually sent friend request out. And then if those people actually end up accepting my friend request, Friender will know, okay, hey, where did this person come from? What keywords did I use to find them? Because then I can use that data whenever I'm actually unfriending people, and I may decide, okay, hey, if they're a CEO, even if they haven't engaged in my content yet, I don't want to unfriend them quite yet because I'm really interested in the CEOs and having CEOs on my friends list. So hopefully that makes sense. Hopefully you guys actually understood that process. If you have any questions, I'll give you a chance to ask any questions. You can see that I'm down now about 20 friends because I got rid of about 20 friends and I added 20 new friends, all right? But it looks like you guys don't have any questions. So with that, I'm gonna go back now and finish my workout. If you guys would like to get access to Friender and you guys would like to have access to the software and also have me personally help you make money from Facebook, how to find new leads, how to convert them into paying customers, all you gotta do is let me know and I'll get you all set up.